Well, thanks to San Jose firefighters, some special children got early Christmas presents today. Santa Claus arrived at the Santa Clara County Children's Shelter with four antique fire trucks loaded with toys. The firefighters donated more than $10,000 worth of toys to children who will not be having Christmas with their families.
Well, the children that are here are all dependents of the court. That means that they are victims of child abuse of some type, that either their parents have been able to offer them a good home or they're victims of physical or sexual abuse.
This year, the children at the shelter got games, dolls, and even a video game. This is the second year that San Jose firefighters have played Santa Claus for the battered children. And Oakland's finest got into the holiday spirit today by passing out baskets of food and toys to Oakland's needy. The giveaway is organized by the Police Officers Association. During the year, the officers gather the names of people who may need help. Those who were not able to pick up the donated food had it delivered to them by Oakland police officers. Two boxes for each house, one of fresh and canned foods and the other filled with Christmas-wrapped packages.
It's been more than a decade since San Francisco's Haight-Ashbury district was known as the world's hippie capital, although some reminders of the Love Generation are still in the area. But now, one of the last reminders is about to be replaced by a franchise pizza parlor. Randy Shandeville reports.
I heard many men lying, I saw many more dying, but I ain't marching anymore.
Free concerts in the park, mind-expanding drugs, peace and love. That was the idealistic dream of the late 60s in the Haight-Ashbury. But in the early 70s, the dream became hazy, and the Haight became a slum filled with burnt-out hippies and rip-off drug dealers. Into the abyss came a little bit of bohemia, the Grand Piano Coffee House. Lexi Ahrens opened it 10 years ago. Here, some of the troubled street people could listen to soothing music for a change, talk over a cup of coffee for hours without being forced to buy more, play chess, or just sit and read. Most people appreciated the nurturing atmosphere, but according to Lexi Ahrens, some people in the Haight are so burnt out on drugs that their daily behavior burned her out.
I ought to have an endurance medal of some sort. I'd be able to stay here this long. But it's time to get out because I'm tired. I'm really tired. I may not look it, but I've had enough.
So next month, Lexi is selling her lease to, now try to imagine this on Haight Street, Round Table Pizza. Customers here are already feeling the loss.
It's a comfortable, well-liked coffee house.
Think you'll get any of the same feelings from Round Table Pizza?
Oh, definitely not. No way.
There's something deeply important about this place. Classic. It has structure. I mean, it's not promiscuous, but it's a place of tolerance.
The managers of Round Table Pizza say they'll still let people linger and still let people play chess. But most people on Haight Street feel that replacing the grand piano with a franchise pizza parlor is like replacing mom with a robot. In San Francisco, Randy Shandeville, KTVU, Channel 2 News.
Snow is still covering the ground in the Antelope and Owens Valley areas of Southern California, and in the Sierras, it should be a great weekend for skiing. There's plenty of snow, and the forecast calls for mostly clear skies, and it should be a little warmer in the Bay Area tomorrow with highs in the mid to upper 50s. Californians will get their first chance to buy lottery tickets next year, but in Spain, there has been a national lottery for the past 221 years, and today was the day they picked this year's winners. For 3 hours, numbers were pulled out of a drum by children from a Madrid orphanage. Their excitement increased in proportion to the size of the payoff. It peaked when the winning ticket was drawn. It paid more than $73 million, while second prize was worth almost $37 million. The lottery is called El Gordo, the fat one. Tickets cost $147 apiece, but are generally bought by groups of people who pool their money. In all, 500,000 prizes are distributed, making Lottery Day in Spain almost as popular as Christmas. I can figure that one out.
Absolutely. My goodness, what do you do with all that money? It's time tonight for a look at some of the people in the news. Boxing promoter Don King and an associate were in a New York courtroom today. The men pleaded innocent to charges of income tax evasion. A federal grand jury says that the men skimmed more than $1 million in cash, most of it from Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas. Sometime legit actor and more frequently star of porn movies, Harry Reams has money problems. He's filed for bankruptcy. Reams, whose real name is Herbert Striker, says that he owes creditors at least $77,260. His only assets, his furnishings, a 13-year-old car, and $200 in cash. About 2 years ago, West Palm Beach socialite Herbert Pulitzer was embroiled in a bitter and headline-making divorce and custody battle with his wife, Roxanne. The case was finally concluded, as was the marriage, but now Roxanne Pulitzer has filed new papers in a Florida court saying the couple last year, for a short time, quote, resumed a prior intimate relationship. She now wants increased and extended alimony. Well, the threat of terrorism is always in the minds of security people in Washington, so the day a man with a foreign accent delivered a Christmas package for a Navy vice admiral, suspicions were raised. As we said, the man had an accent. The bomb dog sniffing the package acted strangely. An X-ray inspection of the package showed two liquid-filled containers. Believing better safe than sorry, an Army bomb disposal team blew up the package and then examined the remains. They were sorry. It turned out that the package contained two bottles of the best Russian vodka, a gift from a lieutenant commander from the Russian embassy. Merry Christmas, and that's people for that.
George? Stories like that bother me so much.
Did you watch the number one rated team in college football tonight?
I don't think so. I think, well, I'm not going to get into that. I'll hear from too many people. But we'll tell you what happened to BYU and have the Warrior and the Cal stories and all the sports now.